Hi guys. I have a few announcements that I have to make. One, for the people that are waiting for a soap video, I apologize in the delay. I know I was supposed to make that video last week, but I'm not feeling well and I have some other issues that are going on in the state of Delaware. It's nothing legal, just child support matters with James's father. And I'm dealing with that stuff right now and kind of really don't have time to do a compilation of videos, but I will get to it. For those that have orders with me, I have not forgotten about you. I am waiting for key ingredients to arrive from Organic Creations. I absolutely need them. I cannot proceed without them. So they make high quality. They have high quality ingredients. I absolutely love them. I really do. I hate their delivery time because it's so slow. But for the quality of ingredients that they have, I am willing to wait. So I do ask you and implore you to please be patient with me. I have not taken money from anybody that has placed an order as of yet. So again, please, you know, please be patient. I truly appreciate it. Okay, so real quick, Rican Spina, I have not sent your test product out for hair thinning. This is what I made for you. And I sent you an email and I said that it was too, it's thicker than I wanted it to be. Now, for everybody, this is my thinning concoction that I made. It's water and it's made with PSA, shea butter, coconut oil, lots of other goodies in here, okay? It feels really good. You see this? It looks like it would be really heavy in that jar, but it's severely light. Really light. Now, my problem with it is I don't like the consistency of it. It's light, but it looks heavy, and I'm not happy with that. So, I have not mailed that out to you. It is still sitting right here. I have decided to make something else that would benefit both you and me. I don't have thin hair, but I do want something that's going to moisturize and nurture my locks on its way and will help promote thicker hair and some hair growth for you. Hold on a second, please. Rihanna, you need to turn that down. I apologize. Okay, so what I have in here is avocado puree, coconut oil, shea butter, soybean oil, castor oil, a little bit of lemon juice, aloe vera juice, guar gum, coconut milk, silk peptide powder, nettle extract, burdock extract, neem oil, lavender essential oil, sweet orange essential oil, grapefruit seed extract, palm stearic acid, and a tablespoon, and I do mean a tablespoon, of beeswax. That is not enough for a 16-ounce jar to cake up in your hair. It's got palm stearic acid in it. I think I said that already. Probably forgetting a couple other things that the mad scientist put in there. But I like its consistency. It presents like a cream. See here? But see how thick it comes off here? This one is mine. If people are wondering, why are you putting your fingers in his product? No, this one is mine. His is in the freezer cooling completely. Mine is semi-cool. So, it presents like a cream. But it does the same thing as the other one. It's so light. Because the aloe vera juice, you see how fast that just disappeared? And it's not really that greasy. It's just it's because it's on my fingers. And it's you can really feel the moisture in it. And I like that. And I think that that's going to be more beneficial for your grade of hair. Because it's not going to be so heavy. Even though this is heavy but light. This is going to look heavy, but it's going to go in light and it's going to be light. And I think that this is going to be a better success than the other product that I made for you. So that one is in the freezer cooling and that will be going out to you tomorrow. Now, as for experimentations for the rest of the interested peoples, I made this creation not so much with Rika in mind because, you know, I was thinking about this here and I wasn't happy with it. And then I'll show you later in the bathroom, but I found some residue from that other stuff that I was showing you that I mixed. And even though it had great hold and it was soft and was shiny, the inside of my lock ended up with some residue. And I think it's because of the flaxseed gel. not enough water to thin it out, and it was really thick. That's what hair product testing is all about, trial and error. So, I came up with this. I think that if I use this by itself, it's going to have nice hold. But then I got to thinking, is it going to have nice hold? I know it's going to be light, and because it disappears so fast, I needed to have a little bit more substance. And so, I took my Clear Ice Ampro, since it's sitting around doing nothing and I haven't used it to mix with anything. And I use 4 tablespoons of this. Believe me, there was a lot in this jar. It was over the top. That's why I did this. 4 tablespoons of this mixture here. And I took 2 tablespoons of Clear Ice. And I whipped it with the blender. And this is the result. See? Do you hear that? It sounds like gel. Now, I took and I redid a twist already. And this is the second time I've done this video, so I already took the twist out. But we can still show you, anyway, what the results are. So, in the meantime, I'm only doing this because I have to go through the kitchen. Nobody wants to see anybody else's kitchen, right? Okay, so, in the bathroom. It's adjust. And I'm going to show you here. This is where I did my test at. Now, I can show you the top here, as promised. You see this white right here? In there. I can show you on another one. See that? Right there? That's residue from the first one I did. I'm not happy about that at all. And that's why I threw that whole bunch away. I know you're saying waste of ingredients, but you know what? If it's not going to work, then don't do it. Just don't put it in your hair. Okay, so I'm trying to turn for you. This is where I added that mixture that I just made with my lock with the Clear Ice gel. And this is just a test because I have to wash my hair. So this is just to see. This is done on a damp twist, damp lock. Lock slash twist. My hair is knitty already. It's really quick. I mean, it's not completely knitted. I'm not going to say that, but quick. Now, compare this. This is the one I just did. Nice hold. Firm, solid, not too tight. To like that one. Or, hold on a second. My eyes. Oh. Okay. Or these that I did. It looks better. You can see that? That looks completely better. Yeah, so I'm happy about that. And I look like I'm crying now because my eyes are burning. And I walked through the kitchen and I think he chopped onions and he didn't rinse the stuff off. So I look like I'm crying. My eyes are burning. Okay, so very, very happy about the next result. And of course, you know, when I go to retwist my hair, I'm going to let you know. But that, oh, did I say avocado puree? I think I did. I ground it down really, really as fine as I can get it. It was mushy. And I like the color and everything. And I put lemon juice on top of the avocado to keep it from oxidizing, because if you leave an avocado out with air around it without putting any lemon or something acidic on it to keep oxidation at bay, it's just going to brown on you and you're not going to be able to use it. So I mixed it with lemon juice and it was good to go. So I'm really happy with the results. Okay, so that's all I wanted to say today. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.